Hi everyone, myself Kalyan Kumar. I'm working in Huawei Bangalore Center and I'm heading the Cloudify Network open source team. Currently, we are working on various open sources like Edge Gallery, Acrino, ONAP, Exivela. And today, me and my colleague Gaurav are going to present you about Edge Gallery platform, which is open source MEC platform from the Huawei. Today's agenda is something like this. Edge Gallery positioning and its scope, technical architecture about the Edge Gallery, and the current community progress of the Edge Gallery, and the use case demo. B2B ecosystem heavily depends upon the MEC industry application ecosystem prosperity. And in order to achieve this, what we need is open MEC platform that is built over heterogeneous hardware platforms with support of easily integration and quick rollout of MEC applications. And this will result in a rich industry application ecosystem and solving the various vertical industry problems in much effective way. And we are trying to bring Edge Gallery in this scope. Currently, there is no unified platform for the innovation achievements in the industry. And there is no closed loop business is being formed, and projects are almost impossible to replicate. That's making it more hard. And most of the things needed for MEC, like industrial IoT platform, software capabilities, APIs are spread in bits and pieces. And there is a lack of industry platform to build a unified platform leveraging all these bits and pieces for the enterprise digital transformation, okay, to provide end-to-end solution for various vertical industry. But the core challenge faced by the MEC ecosystem is not changing 0 to 1 or 1 to 10. Instead, it is how to make it hundreds, then how to evolve into 10,000. So there's a big wide gap in this ecosystem to have a unified industrial platform to solve all these problems. Considering overall requirement and the need of the industry, from Huawei, we have come up with an Edge Gallery platform, which is unified open MEC platform, positioning as a carrier-led edge computing architecture in order to accelerate commercial adoption of this platform and resulting in rich B2B ecosystem. The idea is to build open source edge computing platform, which is most compatible with connection and computing in the telco industry with value propositions like providing 5G native connection capability, adopting Edge native to make edge services more trustworthy and manageable, and building diversified open ecosystem with support of heterogeneous hardware platforms and quickly onboard and rollout of the applications. And Edge Gallery technology vision is spread across these three important areas, like I mentioned in the previous slide, 5G native connectivity and edge native architecture and diversified open ecosystem. And 5G native connectivity is nothing but interconnection with the latest 5G network and having 5G network elements in it, and 3GPP or ETSI compliant about 5G capability, and efficient network data plane and support of latency sensitive network like TSN and built-in value-added network function support on this 5G native. On in case of edge native platform, we want it to be more lightweight resource management, full stack security mechanism, highly trusted management and operation, and support many new edge native technology like edge mesh, edge AI, edge data, edge SecOps. Okay, so many such technologies that can be adopted in this. And on diversified open edge ecosystem, we are looking at simplified application development and providing a good development chain tools to the end user to develop to quickly develop the application and roll out the application, and convenient application verification, providing online simulation sandbox, and providing real 5G network experimental network, and unified authentication and interworking, and multi-ecosystem sharing, like integrating with the public cloud and interop with other commercial platforms. So considering all these visions, the Edge Gallery is taken into shape. In order to provide the solution for the vertical industry, having quick development and rollout of the application is need of the hour. The focus is on a high value scenario, especially to quickly integrate it, the already available valuable application, and end-to-end integration within the days based on end terminal network application in real environment, end-to-end tool chain, enabling quick application rollout from the lab environment to the live environment, especially into the production environment. So this is how, if you look at it, like the complete sequence, like whether it's integrating third-party applications or you are developing by yourself, okay, then having it, testing it and certifying it to working on this platform and releasing it to the app repository. So now we'll go in detail about the technical architecture about the Edge Gallery. The architecture of the Edge Gallery is divided into basically five parts. The first part is MEP, that is MEP is autonomous rich in platform and network capabilities, like QoS, DNS, location service, any other the 5G services, and also support heterogeneous hardware architectures like x86, ARM, GPU, etc. And the second part is MEC orchestration for application orchestration, for application LCM, FCAPS, policy-driven closed loops. And the third part is MECM app repository, which is unified app package format, a standardized API between operator app and MECM. And fourth part is providing a MEC development platform, which will provide you the development tool chains, SDK, API, and sandbox feature for application development and migration, packaging, and testing. And the fifth part is application test platform, and this is for automated application certification, test case management, customization, and visualizing the test reports. So all three together form the Edge Gallery platform. Finally, Edge Gallery also uses a cloud connector to implement the interconnection between the open source edge platform and the public cloud ecosystem, so that applications on the cloud can be deployed at the edge easily. Currently, Edge Gallery plans to share the applications with the VoIP public cloud with agent plugins. In future, the plan is to gradually share the applications with other public clouds also. in order to have rich capability of the Edge Gallery platform, it's considering top 10 edge native technologies to support, like edge infra, edge security, edge collaboration, edge framework, edge DevSecOps, edge orchestrator, like this. So these are all, some of them already developed and integrated into the platform, like edge AI, edge orchestration, etc. So many others are planned or in pipeline. So there are three technological megatrends, okay, and especially when it comes to the Lighthouse factory production, okay, connectivity, intelligence, and flexible automation. And these are the main principal drivers of the industrial revolution paradigm shift into the smart production. And Lighthouse manufacturers are sprinting ahead with the digital transformation and analytics and changing the rules of the game. Lighthouse factories are implementing advanced manufacturing and AI-driven technology at a scale and seeing the significant gains. At broader scale of innovation across the value chain is need of the hour to ensure more winners share the spoils. And as shown in this picture, Edge Gallery can perfectly fits here to provide end-to-end solution. So this Lighthouse factory, whether it's for the industrial revolution or the next future industrial fire revolution, so Edge Gallery can fit perfectly in this to leverage all these AI, virtual reality, augmented reality, big data, all these new technology, it would leverage to provide the end-to-end solution, and the vertical industry can benefit from this. Edge Gallery can also be used in industrial vision solution for various quality inspections in the production, like appearance inspection, surface quality inspection. So many quality inspections can be done using this one. And Edge Gallery perfectly fits into this one. And my colleague Gaurav will cover more in detail on this using one of the use case, like a PCB defect detection. Edge Gallery is hatched early last year. From that, it has progressed pretty well in very short time. Of just 1 year, with the rich platform capabilities, rich developer tool chain, security optimization, with active contribution from the various community members. So this picture depicts the journey of various releases of the Edge Gallery. Now, let's see what is the community behind this Edge Gallery and what is the progress of this community in order to bring up this Edge Gallery platform. The Edge Gallery open source community is growing steadily after its first release, which is on August last year. And this picture depicts successful journey of last 1 year. And many industry partners from various streams, like telco operators, public cloud operators, app developers, have joined hand in this community and are actively contributing for this platform. And these are the various members who are part of the Edge Gallery. There are 8 senior members and 19 normal members, okay? And Edge Gallery has already integrated, developed, okay, nearly 150 applications, out of which B2B are around 65, B2C are around 85 applications. The major focus of Edge Gallery is on the 5 industries currently: smart campus, industrial manufacturing, transportation and logistics, gaming, safety, and other industry. So there are already nearly 50 organizations have joined hand with this open source, and there are nearly 300 people are actively contributing in this community. And Edge Gallery is already is part of that 25 innovation incubation based deployment in various provinces in China. Edge Gallery works extensively with upstream and downstream industry organization bodies for better alignment and adoption, whether it's with LFH or GSMA, ETSI. Okay, so it works with various industry so that it can quickly become a de facto standard. It can adopt all those things, new innovations, okay, new changes are quickly adapted into the platform. These are some of the useful links for anybody who would wish to be part of this beautiful journey of the Edge Gallery open source. You are all most welcome to join this open source. Thank you for your time. Now my colleague Gaurav will take over and give the demo of the Edge Gallery use case, especially the PCB defect demo. Over to you, Gaurav.
Thanks, Kalyan. For next couple of minutes, we are going to see Edge Gallery in action. Let me start with a brief introduction of the demo. There are two user scenarios supported by Edge Gallery. The first one is an application integration, wherein an application vendor wanted to integrate his existing application with Edge Gallery. As part of application integration workflow, first step is to upload an application image and deployment related artifacts to Edge Gallery. Second step is to do a sandbox test, wherein an application vendor can leverage Edge Gallery provided sandbox features to carry out its application deployment and test. The next step is a packaging, wherein Edge Gallery facilitates auto generation of application package. Then comes the certification test. For this, Edge Gallery provides a flexible means to manage test suites and test cases. Also, an application vendor can select some of these test suites against which he wanted to certify his application. Upon successful certification of application, an application is released to an application store. Now, at this point of time, an application has been successfully onboarded to an Edge Gallery store. From an application store, application can either be federated to a third party or an operator app store, or it could be picked via MEC manager. Now MEC manager carries out the deployment of this application to the desired edges. Also, it does the lifecycle management of say. The second user scenario is an application development wherein an application vendor wanted to leverage Edge Gallery provided capabilities to carry out his development. The first step in this workflow is a capability selection. So Edge Gallery provides this set of platform capabilities which could be leveraged during an application development. The next step is an application development itself, wherein application vendor carries out the development of his application by using the capabilities which he has selected in a previous step. All the later steps of application development is same with the application integration. Today, as the time is limited, I'll only be demonstrating an application integration flow with the help of a demo PCB defect detection application. As part of this demo, I am going to show three portals. The first one is a developer platform portal, which includes all the steps from the image upload till the certification. Then there is an application store portal to see all the onboarded application. And at last, there is a MEC manager portal to deploy and to manage an application. So now let me quickly switch to the portals. So this is a developer platform portal It includes tool chains, which could be helpful during the development. It also includes an ability center, which has multiple platform capabilities, which could be leveraged during the development. These capabilities are there in multiple categories. It includes platform services, network services, AI related video database, etc. A user can get details about any of these services by referring to the service docs which is available. Also, user can try out these APIs by using the online emulator which comes with each and every service. Now, to start with a development or an integration, a new project has to be created. As ours is an integration scenario, I will be starting an application integration project. Few of the application details has to be filled in, including the application name, version of an application, a provider, a workload type, which could be either a container or a VM, an architecture, which could be an x86 or an ARM architecture, industry and the type, icon for an application, and a brief description. So now a project has been successfully created. The next step is a deployment test, as part of which, firstly, an application image has to be uploaded, which could be done in two modes. The mode one is to upload an app image to a public repository. A mode two is to upload an app image to an Edge Gallery provided repository. To save time, I have already pre-uploaded all the required images to Edge Gallery repository. So I can move on to a next step, which is to configure deployment files. This can again be done in two modes. Mode one is to upload a deployment YAML file directly. Mode two is to provide deployment details, and the deployment YAML file will be auto-created by the system. For this demo, I have a deployment YAML file available in NVD, so I'll be uploading that. There are set of checks which are performed over an uploaded file, including a format check, image information, service information, in order to check the correctness of the file. The next step is a deployment test itself, as part of which, firstly, a user has to select a testing environment, which could be a 5G environment and a sandbox environment. For this demo, I will be selecting a sandbox environment and starting the deployment. As part of the deployment, firstly, a deployment files are created. Then a test node is being assigned, after which an application is being instantiated on this test node. And at last, system waits to get the deployment status of an application. This process is going to take a couple of minutes. So we can see the progress bar here. Now, currently the application has been instantiated and the system is waiting to get the deployment status. So the application deployment is successful and the deployment result can be viewed down. So in total, there are three pods which has been deployed as part of this application. Now a VNC client is also provided, using which an application vendor can log in to this test node and carry out further tests related to the application. Before moving on to a next step, it is a best practice to release the resources. A next step is an application release, for which first of all an application configuration has to be provided, including an application description file, which is nothing but a .md file. Application rules, which includes traffic rules and DNS rule, can also be added. If this application is a producer application and wanted to list his producing service as part of an ability center, he can add the configuration here. For our demo, I'll be skipping these two steps and I'll be saving the configuration. Upon successfully saving the configuration, an application package is generated and the detail of the application package can be seen here. The next step is an application certification. So there are set of test suits which are available for this demo. I will be certifying the application against a community test suit. The community test suit has test cases in three categories. The first one is a compliance test cases. The second category is a sandbox test cases. And the third category is a security test cases. Under sandbox test cases, the application will be instantiated, terminated, and the dependency check would be done. Under the security test cases, all the security tests would be performed and the status can be seen above. On successful execution of this test suite, user can view and can download the detailed certification report. I'll be moving on to a next step, which is to publish this application to an application store. Okay, so it has been successfully published to an app store. And with this, we have seen all the steps related to a developer platform portal. And I will be switching on to an app store portal. So this is an application store portal. We can move to an app warehouse and we can see that the app which we have published is available as part of the app warehouse. User can download the application package, can get the details about the application, can also provide a comment and score related to this application. As part of my app section, user can manage all the onboarded application. And as part of apps share, the application could be federated to a third party or an operator application store. Now I'll be switching on to the last portal, which is an MEC manager portal. So MEC manager is something which is an orchestrator and a manager of Edge Gallery. We can view all the nodes details, all the edge nodes which are available in the topology, can get details about these edge nodes, including their hardware, software capabilities and other details. User can also view all the applications which has been instantiated. Currently, there is none. Now to deploy a PCB demo application, the first step here is to synchronize the package with MEC manager. Then we can distribute this particular package to one of the test node. The status could be seen here. The package is getting distributed to this host IP. And we can see that it has been successfully distributed. Now we can deploy or instantiate this application. Few details needs to be added, like an app name, app description, and in case if there are any hardware capabilities needed by this application. So now application instantiation is in progress to this particular MEC host. We can see that the app has been instantiated successfully, and this is the last step of our demo. Now we can see the demo app itself. So this is a demo application. It is an AI-based application for PCB defect detection in PCB production line. There are a set of pre-configured factory. We can select one of it. We can add a production line for this factory, associate a camera with it, and can start processing. So the processing of this PCB has been started. And we can see that each and every PCB is being scanned for the defects. The output could be seen in this window. The red shows that the PCB is defective. Green shows that there is no defect in the PCB. Detailed results could be viewed. And in case there is a defect in a PCB, the location and type of defect would be shown by this application. So this is all what I have for today for Edge Gallery demo. Thank you.